Blackstone Audio presents The Call of Earth, Homecoming, Volume 2, by Orson Scott Card. To Dave Dollahite, teacher and dreamer, husband and father, friend and fellow citizen. Prologue. The master computer of the planet Harmony was not designed to interfere so directly in human affairs. It was deeply disturbed by the fact that it had just provoked young Nyafai to murder Gabialovix. But how could the master computer return to Earth without the index? And how could Nyafai have got the index without killing Gabialovix? There was no other way. Or was there? I am old, said the master computer to itself, 40 million years old. A machine designed to last for nowhere near this long. How can I be sure that my judgment is right? And yet I caused a man to die for my judgment, and young Nyafai is suffering the pangs of guilt because of what I urged him to do. All of this in order to carry the index back to Zvezda Krug, so I could return to Earth. If only I could speak to the Keeper of Earth. If only the Keeper could tell me what to do now. Then I could act with confidence. Then I would not have to doubt my every action, to wonder if everything I do might not be the product of my own decay. The master computer needed so badly to speak to the Keeper. Yet it could not speak to the Keeper except by returning to Earth. It was so frustratingly circular. The master computer could not act wisely without the help of the Keeper. It had to act wisely in order to get to the Keeper. What now? What now? I need wisdom, and yet who can guide me? I have vastly more knowledge than any human can hope to master, and yet I have no minds but human minds to counsel me. Was it possible that human minds might be enough? No computer could ever be so brilliantly disorganized as the human brain. Humans made the most astonishing decisions based on mere fragments of data, because their brain recombined them in strange and truthful ways. It was possible, surely, that some useful wisdom might be extracted from them. Then again, maybe not, but it was worth trying, wasn't it? The master computer reached out through its satellites and sent images into the minds of those humans most receptive to its transmissions. These images from the master computer began to move through their memories, forcing their minds to deal with them, to fit them together, to make sense of them, to make from them the strange and powerful stories they called dreams. Perhaps in the next few days, the next few weeks, their dreams would bring to the surface some connection or understanding that the master computer could use to help it decide how to bring the best of them out of the planet Harmony and take home to Earth. All these years I have taught and guided, shaped and protected them. Now, in the end of my life, are they ready to teach and guide, shape and protect me? So unlikely. So unlikely. I will surely be forced to decide it all myself, and when I do, I will surely do it wrong. Perhaps I should not act at all. Perhaps I should not act at all. I should not act, will not, must, wait. Wait. Again. Wait. 1. Betrayal. The dream of the general. General Vozmyuzhalnoy Vozmyozhno awoke from his dream, sweating, moaning. He opened his eyes, reached out with his hand, clutching. A hand caught his own, held it. A man's hand. It was General Plodyorodinui. his most trusted lieutenant, his dearest friend, his inmost heart. You were dreaming, Moozh. It was the nickname that only Plod dared to use to his face. Yes, I was. Vozmyuzhalnoy, Moozh, shuddered at the memory. Such a dream. Was it portentous? Horrifying, anyway.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.